It's a safe bridge. Continue to use it with confidence.
Last year, we were looking at the design of the light rail transit system that is going to be using the Washington Avenue Bridge. And we had discussions about the bridge as a whole and what it could handle. There could be a situation on this, the pedestrian deck, where if you get a lot of people, and I mean a lot of people, standing around the edges or standing around some of the columns, that the columns could actually start to bend. We decided to place the people inside the enclosure and keep them focused toward the middle of the bridge, absolutely the safest place to be. Well, the 35W bridge collapse has caused us to take a look at all our bridges across the entire state. I think it's affected everyone's view of how bridges operate. We appreciate that everyone has to learn a little bit of patience while they're using it.
Well, it sucks because I have to go to marching band every day. And since I bike, it makes my trip like almost 15 minutes longer, so I have to leave even earlier and I get home later, and it sucks because I don't have a lot of extra time now.
Just being outside, biking, having to get off your bike, and then kind of the difficulty of some people don't choose to get off their bikes when they're in the hallway, in this corridor here, which endangers people who are walking. So it's a little bit of a mix of kind of a bad transportation and a disappointment that the bridge can't be, you know, fixed sooner or stuff, but you have to accept it for safety. So
I don't think anything's really going wrong with the bridge.
Our goal is to have the fences back down for you by April 1st of next year.